I asked my mentor, Chuck Schwab, how was it that he coped with dyslexia? That's something that holds millions of people back as a handicap, a difficulty in being able to perform English functions, you know, letters in a word and words in a sentence, something that almost got him kicked out of college. How was it that he was able to create this huge, iconic transformation in financial services and still be held back by this so-called handicap? Listen to Chuck Schwab. It wasn't a handicap at all. It was his genius.
I got through college by the, by a lot of luck, and sometimes I think even mirrors, because I flunked English A a couple of times at Stanford, and it was a very debilitating, depressing thing for me to do that, because I was thought I was pretty bright, and I didn't realize how incompetent I was in the skill of writing. In some respects, the positive side of this learning issue thing was probably my early recognition that I wasn't strong in every component of reading and writing, all those kinds of things, that I needed to have other people who could help me out in different parts of the business that I was developing. A lot of people who are brilliant, we'll say, who are brilliant entrepreneurs, think they can do everything, and they don't develop the team that they need to have in order to accomplish the various levels that you're going to reach in your growth curve as a successful company. And so at every level this Schwab has moved to, I've been able to, I think, recognize my strengths and my deficits and build up around me with great people in the deficit area. And I think that probably has been maybe the single most important benefit that I achieved or received from having this learning issue early on in my life.